Hello and welcome to the first of a series of tutorials on the Bureau of Crime Statistics and Research Crime Mapping Tool. This application contains a variety of easy-to-use features that will allow you to access information on crime, offenders and victims within New South Wales LGAs, suburbs and postcodes as recorded by New South Wales Police. The tool is updated every 3 months with the most recent data available. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use the tool's main features. The tool is located on BOCSARs homepage. The tool opens onto the map view with offence types on the left-hand side. There are over 60 offences listed within the drop-down tabs. Along the top of the output view, which in this case is the map, is the title, which shows your selections. Directly below the title are tabs including the rate map, table, and graphs. On the right-hand side are fields for the year and geographical location, and below them are refresh, print, and save, which is handy if you want to use any of the outputs in your own presentations or papers, and help buttons. Zooming options are also available at the bottom of the map view. The left-hand panel is a logical place to start your query as it allows you to select your offence type and any subcategories. By default, the map is set to assault. To change the offence, click on the chosen top-level offence type, for example assault, and if required, select the second level, non-domestic assault. You'll notice the title across the top now reflects both levels of offences. Always check the title to make sure your selections have been successfully applied. If you want more detailed information, apply the required advanced filters. You can select one of three counting units at a time: incidents, which is a default, offenders, and victims. Within each option, additional drop-down menus will appear. You can select one from each category. I'm going to refine my search to explore incidents of non-domestic assault that occurred at night and were alcohol related. The selected tabs are now highlighted and the title has been updated. Data for the whole of New South Wales is now available for viewing within the map, table and graphs. You can also continue to refine your search if necessary, as I'll continue to explain. The map shows the rate of crime occurring across New South Wales. It updates each time a filter is added. A colour-coded legend explaining the rates is available on the left-hand side. The darker the colour, the higher the rate. You can zoom in and out of the map. Use a hand icon to select specific geographical locations. A pop-up window will appear for the selection with trend and rate information. Re-click to deselect. If you want to compare different locations, click each desired location. By default, LGAs are selected, but this can be changed by typing or selecting a postcode or suburb in the top right box. The year can also be changed in the adjacent date field. Once all desired locations have been selected, switch to table or graph view to see further representations. The default table shows the trends, count and rates for all LGAs of New South Wales. If you made geographical selections within the map view, these will appear at the top of the table highlighted in blue. You can continue to select, deselect, or change locations and geographical type by clicking them within the table or searching within the geographical field. You can only view one geographical type at a time, so only postcodes or LGAs or suburbs. You can't combine each of these and any previous selections will disappear. The default is 2 years. You can increase this by selecting the year drop-down box below the table tab. Three visual representations of the selected data are provided in the Graphs tab. From the drop-down box, select from a trend graph, which is the default, or a column or pie graph. Within the pie graph, you can filter by premises, time of week, time of day, or alcohol related. For some offences, not all, hotspot maps are available, which shows the density of crime in an area. Currently, the feature is not available because my search is too refined. But if I remove the advanced filter to explore all non-domestic assaults, it now shows along the top bar. You can zoom in and out to get a different perspective of the crime density in a specific area. Caution should be taken when observing the hotspots, as they are intended as a general guide to where crimes are concentrated and should not be used to interpret the specific locations, such as streets, where crime is most prominent. More information on this can be found on our user guide. For further information, go to our help section by clicking on the question mark on the top right. Here you'll find a user guide, facts, and links to more tutorials. Thank you for watching this video. I hope it's been helpful. Good luck with your queries.